Ryan, was that the perfect way to bounce back after Saturday?
Yeah, listen, we said bounce back ability to the boys, and that's what we wanted. You know, listen, they were chomping at the bit, you could see, because although the performance was okay on Saturday, you know, you shouldn't have to play in league football on a pitch like that. But look, we eradicated all the excuses and we said, right, let's get back to winning ways. And, you know, it's going to be a tough test, we know. Grimsby in decent enough form, Ollie's gone in there and turned him round. So we felt that they'd try and play a little bit, which fair play to them. But I think, as you've seen, we were absolutely clinical, especially in the first half. I'd like to be a bit more clinical second half, but look, I always want more, don't I? But pleasing with 3 points, clean sheet and 3 goals.
You set up very attacking-wise. Is that what you referred to this then when you said you knew Grimsby would come for a game and you wanted to go out and attack?
Yeah, of course, we always do, especially at home. We knew they'd play, you know, a 4-3-3 and three attackers up front and, you know, three up against our three in there, and we just moved it around a little bit and, you know, just a little bit tactical in terms of moving one or two players here, there, and in different positions. But we always felt that, you know, we, especially at home, we play our game, our passing game, and side to side, and breaking lines, and, you know, getting players in good areas. We always feel we'd be a threat, not just for Grimsby, but for anyone. And listen, pleased that we've done it.
The front two both scored tonight, or the starting front two both scored tonight. I made that 13 goals. In 13 games since Luke came into the side after being recalled.
Well, there's
a night. So that's a great combination.
Oh, listen, it's great. Yeah, it's a great combination. But again, we've got other players who are just as good. I never single anyone out. I don't know. You'd have to check the goals. But I think Ryan Hardy's claiming the two of them because I think the linesman's actually give it to him. Which look for Luke, we can say he had it and whatever. But it don't really matter. It does for the lads, obviously, as strikers and former strikers, it does. But, you know, look, they should be pleased that we've got 3 points and 3 goals and a clean sheet, and that's the most important thing. But no, as you say, they've been terrific, whoever plays up there.
I thought the speed of thought as well as the speed of play was quite fantastic. I mean, Ryan Hardy's goal especially, I mean, it's a quick interception, quick ball, the striker's on it straight away, and the next thing is in the back of the net. I mean, as a striker yourself, you must appreciate that movement.
Oh, 100%, yeah. Listen, I call him a greyhound. He's rapido, though. He says I'm coming out of trap two today and not trap four. But he's rapid though. And when he gets in there, he's calm and composed. Sometimes you can be a bit too much composed and calm, but no, listen, fair play to him. Every time he's got in positions, we're confident that he's going to hit the back of the net.
He's coming in and taking his chance. I thought the other two came out, George, obviously, we know what he can do. Connor as well.
Excellent.
What a squad you've got.
Yeah, and that's what I said. That, look, you know, when one, you have one little bit of setback, you know, you've always got one of your mates to step in. I've just said that to the lads in there. Look, we've got a tremendous squad, and when one opportunity goes, another one arises. I said, don't give me 3-4 weeks' time and come to me and say, why didn't I take that opportunity? Because they've got the opportunities now, you know. Fad is playing that left side now while Gaz is suspended, and, you know, George has come in that side and done a terrific job, and Connor was fantastic in there again. And, you know, he come and see me yesterday and said, you know, am I going to get a chance? I said, yeah, but go and take it. And listen, he's done great tonight. He's burst forward the ball. His pass completion was probably, I'd say, 95%. He was very good. And that's what we want. But listen, I've got no questions when I have to put Connor Grant in the team or Ryan Hardy or George Cooper, because, as I say, I never single anyone out. They're all just as much as each and every single person we've got in the building. That's why we feel we've got a good enough squad.
People who weren't here or weren't watching an iPhone might say, well, it's 3-0 at half time, you didn't get any goals second half, but you hit the bar twice.
Yeah, post.
Forces it, or hit the woodwork twice.
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah. And then the goalkeeper had to make some saves as well. So you kept at it.
Yeah, listen, we kept at it. It's always tough, innit? As you say to the lads, you know, just keep going, keep getting more, and just keep kind of going. But look, fair play to Grimsby. They come out and they change shape a little bit and matched us up and went 3-5-2 and, you know, tried to cause a few problems. They had a couple of half chances, that's not, you know, but our lads put the bodies on the line and, you know, they had a few corners which we dealt with quite well. But again, look, you know, it's just a fantastic team performance, what we wanted. Yeah, it's never going to be easy going out again. People think, oh, 3.5 times going to be six. It's never going to be the case, because when you've got an experienced manager in Ian Holloway, he ain't going to let that happen. Hence, he matched us up. But listen, all I'm pleased with is another 3 points on the board, where we're trying to get to. Clean sheet and 3 more goals.
And handily positioned in the table?
I haven't looked yet, but I believe, yeah.
Okay.
Well, I'll leave that for you.
Thank you.